Hello, I am Dr. G. Mahesh, Associate Professor in Department of CSC, Sagaram Krishnaraja Engineering College, Bembaram. The present topic is joints in SQL in DBMS course. The course code is B17CS3104. The main objectives of this PPT are, first of all, to apply set operations of SQL, and then to obtain data in two or more tables, and then to apply joins in SQL. Let us see the different set operations. First of all, union. The union gives you the results of set 1 and also set 2. And intersection operation gives you the common elements in set 1 and set 2. And then except operator will give you the elements that are there in the set 1 but not in set 2. For operating these operations in SQL, I demonstrate you using teacher table and student table. In teacher table, there is EMP number, ename, and job of different teachers. One is Mahesh, another employee or teacher is Richie, and another teacher is Rama, who is also a student doing the PhD. And in the student table, there are Pawan and Anu. Both these tables have the same number of columns, therefore we can perform these operations. Therefore, first of all, for obtaining the data from the teacher table, you use select star from teacher. For obtaining data from the student table, you use select star from student. If you want union of these two tables, then you have to apply union operator between these two results. Then the results will be 10 Mahesh, 20 Richie, and then 3 Rama, which comes only once, and then 4 Pawan and 5 Anu. Let us see the intersection operation between teacher and student. That means the teachers who are also students, that query we want. Then you have to apply intersection operation between these two queries, select star from teacher, intersect select star from student. Then the result will be 3 Rama PhD. Let us see the except operator. That is the elements containing in one set but not in another set. For this operation, there is except operator in SQL, but it may be in some languages used in Oracle, you use minus also. Let us see the except operator here. Therefore, first of all, select star from teacher, except or minus, select a star from student. That will give you the teachers that are not students. The result will be 10 Mahesh teacher, 20 Richie teacher. Those are all teachers but not students. Let us see the queries on two or more tables. One of the ways is a nested queries. A query within another query is known as nested query. For example, we want location of Scott department. We have to join two tables, because in EMP table we can know the department number but not the location. Therefore, first of all, obtain the department number of Scott from EMP table, and then substitute it in the query of department table obtaining location.
Therefore, the final query will be select LOC from DBPT where DBPT number is equal to select department number from EMP where ename is Scott. Therefore, first of all, obtain the department number of Scott in EMP and then substitute in department table and obtain the query. The result will be the department name of Scott is research. The next query is also a nested query that is the query is names of employees working in accounting department. We can obtain accounting department department number from a DBPT table and then we can substitute it in the query of EMP table. Therefore, select a DBPT number from DBPT where DNAME is equal to accounting and then substitute this department number in the external query. Select DNAME from EMP where DBPT number is equal to DBPT number of accounting. The result will be DNAME is equal to research. Like this. And names of employees are Clark, King and Miller. Next, let us see another nested query known as a correlated nested query. Generally, what happens in a nested query is the substitute values of inner query in outer queries. But correlated nested query, outer query results are substituted in inner query. Now, the example is display employee numbers whose salary is greater than his manager salary. We can obtain EMP number for each and every employee, but if you want the salaries of the managers, you have to do another query. Therefore, first of all, obtain the manager number of that particular employee and see the salary. So, the query is select a sal from EMP where EMP number is equal to the manager number of that employee. Therefore, the outer query result is substituted in the inner query and the final query will be select EMP number for EMP, the alias name is E, where his salary is greater than his manager salary. The result will be 7788 and also 7902. 7902 is Ford, he is analyst, the manager is again Jones with 2975.
Now let us see how to obtain data from more than one table using joins. So join is nothing but using the select statement and substituting more than one table in selection list and in the where clause you can mention the joining condition. That is what is known as a join. Therefore, let us see first kind of join without condition known as Cartesian product. Therefore, if you give select star from student comma marks the two table names without any condition, then it will give you the Cartesian product of the two tables rows, all the combinations of all the rows. Therefore, the result will be like this, first row with all the first rows of the second table. Second row of first table with all the rows of second table, third row of first table and all the rows of second table. Now let us see what is meant by conditional join. In conditional join, you will give condition of joining the two tables in the where clause. For this also, first of all, Cartesian product is performed, that is without giving the condition. Then all the rows combinations will come and then you have to give the condition. Here the condition is you have to join the student table with marks table and obtain the marks of students whose serial number is less than that student's serial number. Therefore the condition is student dot serial number less than marks dot serial number. The result will be like this, one Rama BTech and 2 DBMS 50, that is 1 is less than 2. For this row only this is satisfied. Another option of giving the conditional join is without comma you can give join keyword here and instead of where clause you have to give on and then the condition. This is also conditional join using the keyword join. And then let us see equijoin. Equijoin is also like conditional join. Then Cartesian product is first performed and then the condition is given, but the condition here is equality condition, which will give you the matching rows of a student along with the marks rows which is matched with the student rows using the equi condition. This is known as equi join. Therefore, for each and every row in the result, you have to check serial number is the same for both these things or not, and then the result will be displayed. Another option of giving equi join is instead of comma, you have to give join keyword, and instead of where clause, you have to give on keyword. Now let us see left outer join. Left outer join is also like equi join, in which the matching rows of the two tables will come as output in addition to unmatched row of left side table. Therefore, it is also first of all performs Cartesian product, and then equi join condition you have to give, but you have to give an extra symbol plus symbol in the equi condition, that is a plus symbol on the right side, because we are performing a left outer join. You have to join null values of the right side table. And another option of giving a left outer join is you can also give instead of comma left outer join, and instead of where clause you have to give on. Here you don't have to mention plus symbol. The result will be you also get a 3 chord BTEC details also who has not written any exam. Now let us see right outer join. It will give you the matching rows of the two tables along with the unmatched row of the second table. Again, Cartesian product is performed, equi join is performed, but you have to give the plus symbol on the left side. That means you have to add null values to the left side table like this. And the second option is instead of giving comma here, you can also give right outer join, and instead of where clause, you can also give on keyword. Next comes a full outer join, in which matching rows of the two tables are obtained. In addition, unmatched rows of left side table and right side table also come in the result. First of all, perform Cartesian product and then equi join, but there is no option of giving plus symbols on both sides. Therefore, directly you have to give the keywords student full outer join marks instead of where clause on and the equi condition. Then the result will be the matched rows of the two tables and unmatched rows of left side and right side table. Now let us see natural join. Natural join is again same as equi join. The only difference is you don't have to give the condition. It automatically takes the condition as the common field names. That is, instead of giving the condition, you can directly give the keyword called join, and before that join you have to mention natural. Then you don't have to give this condition. Therefore, in natural join, the common fields which have the same name in the two tables are joined automatically. The another difference between equi join and natural join is the common field does not appear twice. In this slideshow, we have discussed about set operations and then joins, and finally natural join. Natural keyword can be used with any kind of join.